Father Abraham Mutalib. My dear friends, we are gathered here to witness the marriage ceremony of Jimmy and Stephanie. They were aspiring for this day for many years, and that day has come. So we are all here to pray for them and give all our support in their future life. So let us come to this Mass and this matrimonial ceremony with devotion, and we continue their memories in our prayers. So let us continue with the Holy Mass.
To live in union of heart,
graciously enrich this bride Stephanie and the groom Jimmy with your heavenly gifts, and help them from a form an ideal family that observes your commandments. Enable us, O Lord, to administer this sacrament worthily for your glory and for the good of the human race. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, Lord of all, forever.
Amen.
Hear, O Lord, consider and rend your ears. Forget your people and your father's house.
Rejoice, O Church.
The princess is decked in her heart chamber with the garland molders.
In many colors robes, and she is led to the king. Behind her is the virgin, her companion follows.
With joy and gladness they are led along as they enter the palace of the king. I will cause your name to be celebrated in all generations.
Your wife will be like a beautiful wine within your house. Your children will be like olives in around your table.
There shall be the man be blessed who fears the Lord. The Lord bless you from Zion and all the days of your life. Glory be to the Father, and to the Son, and to the Holy Spirit.
From eternity and forever and ever. Amen.
Rejoice, O Church, the spouse of our Savior. God the Eternal has chosen you as the spouse by love.
Let us pray, peace be with us.
Lord God, when the sweet fragrance of your love wraps over us, and when our souls are enlightened with the knowledge of your truth, may we be found worthy to receive your beloved Son as he appears from the heaven. May we also glorify you and praise you unceasingly in your church, crowned like a spouse with every goodness and grace, for you are the Lord and Creator of all forever and ever.
Amen. May the Savior who said, I am the light of the world, he who follows me will not walk in darkness, be our beacon all the way.
Let us pray, peace be with us.
My Lord, you are truly the one who raises our bodies. You are the Savior of our souls and the preserver of our lives. We are bound always to thank, adore, and glorify you, the Lord of all, forever.
Thank you.
Let us pray, peace be with us.
Glorious, mighty, immortal, and holy God, you who are pleased to dwell in the holy ones, we beseech you, look upon us, pardon us, and show us compassion according to your nature. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the Lord of all forever.
Brothers and sisters, a reading from the book of Sirach. Bless me, O Lord. How blessed is a husband of a really good wife. The number of his days will be doubled. A perfect wife is the joy of her husband. He will live out the years of his life in peace. A good wife is the best of portions, reserved for those who fear the Lord, rich or poor. Their hearts will be glad, their faces cheerful, whatever the season. Praise to you, Lord. Amen.
Brothers and sisters, a reading from the first letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians.
Bless me, my Lord.
May God bless you.
If I speak in the tongues of men or of angels, but do not have love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. If I have the gift of prophecy and can fathom all mysteries and all knowledge, and if I have a faith that can move mountains, but do not have love, I am nothing. If I give all that I possess to the poor and give over my body to hardship that I may boast, but do not have love, I gain nothing. Love is patient, love is kind. It does not envy, it does not boast, it is not proud. It does not dishonor others, it is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with the truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, always perseveres. Praise be to Christ our Lord.
Thank you. Let us stand and listen attentively to the Holy Gospel.
Peace be with you.
With you and with your spirit.
The Holy Gospel of our Lord Jesus Christ, proclaimed by St. Matthew. It is not anyone who says to me, Lord, Lord, who will enter the kingdom of heaven, but the person who does the will of my Father in heaven. When the day comes, many will say to me, Lord, Lord, did we not prophesy in your name, drive out demons in your name, work many miracles in your name? Then I shall tell them to their faces, I have never known you. Away from me, Lord, evil doers. Therefore, everyone who listens to these words of mine and acts on them will be like a sensible man who built his house on rock. Rain came down, floods rose, gales blew and hurled themselves against that house. And it did not fall. It was founded on rock. But everyone who listens to these words of mine and does not act in them will be like a stupid man who built his house on sand. Jesus had now finished what he wanted to say, and his teaching made a deep impression on the people because he taught them with authority unlike their own scribes.
Glory to you, Christ our Lord.
She is hailing from very Catholic Kananaya family, having profound spiritual foundations and faith traditions. Jose and Selin Korakudilil, parents of Stephanie, migrated to USA almost 40 years ago from Kerala. They are living now in Long Island, New York, where they raised three daughters. Jose and Selin gave their daughters the best education possible to become doctors as well as create a solid religious foundation to take with them throughout their lives. Stephanie is the youngest out of the three daughters, and while completing her Doctor of Dental Surgery degree at New York, she met with Jimmy through her friends, I understand. True. Stephanie's parents are very active in our community on various levels. Mr. Jose Korakudilil is one of the founding members and the secretary of St. Stephen Kananaya Foreign Church, New York. Above all, I know Mr. Jose Korakudilil as a man who has exerted great amount of energy and talents for the formation of Kananaya community in New York area, and had worked strenuously for purchasing the Kananaya Community Center that exists today in the Rockland County. I had the good opportunity to work with him during the third Syro Malabar National Convention that held in New Jersey in 2003, where Mr. Jose was the vice chairman and I as the director. Jimmy, I came to know you little late though. However, I understand that your family is also coming from very traditional Catholic Kananaya family belonging to the Archdiocese of Kottayam. I appreciate and congratulate you for the decision to choose a life partner from your own Kananaya community. It shows how much you love your Kananaya heritage and traditions. It is a great example for the younger ones also. I know your parents, Jose and Ambali, migrated to the US 30 years ago from Kerala. They live now in my neighborhood, Elmhurst, Illinois. Jose and Ambali were one of the founding members of the Syro Malabar Cathedral and were active until they moved to the new parish at Maywood Sacred Heart Kananaya Church. Jimmy is the second son who finished his religious education at the Syro Malabar Cathedral. This foundation led you to serve as a Knight of Columbus for your parish. Jimmy earned his master's degree in software engineering from DePaul University and currently works as an IT professional. This led him to receive his commission as a United States Army officer in the Illinois National Guard, where he is currently serving as a lieutenant. Dear Jimmy and Stephanie, I have nothing more to say today since you were preparing yourself several months for this day. God Himself was preparing you for this day from your birth, and recently you have attended the marriage preparation classes that offered from your church. As you enter new terrain in your life, I just want to remind you few key aspects of what you are going to receive today. First, you are called today to the celebration of a sacrament. A sacrament is an external sign of an invisible spiritual reality. In the case of marriage, you are the sacrament. Stephanie, in your beautiful wedding dress, radiant as a bride on her wedding day, you are a sign of beautiful reality, the church. Jimmy and Stephanie, you would have contemplated how to make your married life more joyful, meaningful, fruitful, and giving. You will get millions of instructions, either from your parents or friends, even from the church, how to make your marriage happier. A recent study indicated that if couples attend Holy Mass together each Sunday at least, they have a 50 times greater chance of having a joyful and lasting marriage. Keep in your mind that when you get married today, it is not two of you are getting married here. There is someone else in your midst, that is Jesus Christ. The Spirit of Christ is pouring into your life today through this sacred service. So consult with Jesus whenever you take any decision in your life. We know Jesus was present at the wedding feast at Cana. By performing his first miracle of turning water into wine, Jesus showed great care and attention to those young couples. This same thing Jesus continues even today among you. Don't be afraid. Jesus can turn all your anxieties and worries into into great joy. Secondly, understand that marriage is, like holy orders, is one of the sacraments of service. The Catechism of the Catholic Church tells us that these sacraments are not for ourselves, but are directed towards the salvation of the other. Hence, marriage has got two special missions. What are those missions? Love and life. First, it is for the good of the spouse. How we understand the mission of love? We hear a lot of things about love. There are millions of movie stories that exalt some love of man and woman. Plenty of romantic songs are available in the market. One song I remember, Oru Chiri Kandal, Kani Kandal, Adumadi, Oru Vili Kettal, Mozhi Kettal, Adumadi. In the physical realm, love could be generated by bodily actions. These are all peripheries of love today. The real love we have to search in this book, the Bible. Family that emerges from real marriage is the place where love is celebrated in its fullness. The perfect model of this love has been given by Jesus Christ, who died on the cross for his spouse, the church. According to St. Paul, the marriage relationship of a man and woman is equal to the relationship of Jesus to the church. The matrimony is a sacrament of love which exists for the salvation of others, and the first person you need to save is one beside you. That is your spouse. That is why Pope Francis called in a conference held in Rome for the newly wedded that the sacrament of marriage is an instrument of salvation. Second mission of marriage is life, that you will find in the book of Genesis. God called to Adam and Eve, the first couple, be fruitful and multiply. Each of us is here because of the generosity and the dedication of our parents. Do you know how much your parents aspire to become, to get grandchildren? Fulfill their ambitions. We pray today that God may bless you with your marriage with the children, and we remind you to welcome generously the children God will send to you. So Jimmy and Stephanie, I take this opportunity again to congratulate you, and God may lead you and walk with you and let all your aspirations come to its fullness. And God will continue to bless you and have a married, happy, long married life. Thank you.
Caro Suso.
In reverence and exaltation, let us pray for Jimmy and Stephanie to be united in holy matrimony, saying, Lord, have mercy on them. O heavenly bridegroom, who offered your life for his bride, the church, bless this couple to live a life of sacrifice in mutual love and unity, we pray. O Christ, who invites all to the spiritual banquet of the Word of God, bless this couple to be partakers of the heavenly banquet, having lived an exemplary family life according to your precepts, we pray. O Christ, who taught the indissolubility of marriage, bless this couple to live a happy married life of chastity and fidelity, we pray. O Christ, who favored the bride and the groom in the marriage at the feast of Cana with your presence, bless this couple to live a life of prayer, trusting in your help and relishing your graceful presence, we pray.
For the souls of the faithfully departed from our families, especially our beloved grandparents, that they may join the heavenly saints at the wedding banquet of Christ, we pray. Let us commend one another and ourselves to the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Lord God, bless Jimmy and Stephanie to lead with success the married life they begin in joy and hope. Fill them with your peace and make them worthy to obtain the everlasting crown you have promised your servants. Be gracious to the parents and the dear ones who raise this couple in your love, and bless all those who participate in this sacred ceremony. Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, Lord of all, forever.
Amen. Dear brothers and sisters, Jimmy and Stephanie are going to be united through the sacrament of holy matrimony. The celebrant prays for himself that he may administer the sacrament worthily, in reverence and attentively. Let us now pray in silence.
O God, who in the beginning blessed man with a life partner, we praise your eternal providence. Strengthen me, your servant, to administer worthily the sacrament which unites this bride and groom in your love. Shower upon them your abundant grace, Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit, Lord of all, forever.
Thank you. reverence, bow your head and receive the blessings. And sealed with the sign of life, participate in these holy mysteries attentively and devotedly.
Thank you.
profess our faith. We believe in one God, the Father Almighty,
Creator of all things, visible and invisible, in one Lord Jesus Christ, the only begotten Son of God, the firstborn of all creatures, born of the Father before all ages, and not made, true God from true God, consubstantial with the Father, through him the world were formed, and all things were created. For the sake of us men, and for our salvation, he came down from heaven, and became matter of the Holy Spirit, and became man, and was conceived and born of the Virgin Mary. He suffered and was crucified in the days of Pontius Pilate, died and was buried, and the third day he rose again, as it is written. He ascended into heaven, and he sits at the right hand of his Father. He will come again to judge the dead. We believe in the Holy Spirit, the Spirit of truth, who proceed from the Father and the Son, and the life of all things. We believe in one holy, which for the baptism for the remains of sin, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. Amen.
May God, Lord of all, strengthen you to sing his praises.
Let us pray, peace be with us. Let us pray for the memory of our fathers, the patriarchs and bishops, and for all the priests, deacons, young men and virgins, our parents, brothers and sisters, sons and daughters. Let us remember all the rulers who love Christ and are faithful to him, and all who have departed from this world in true faith. Through the grace of Christ, may his sacrifice obtain for us help, salvation and life everlasting in the kingdom of heaven.
Bless, O Lord, pray for me, brothers and sisters, that this Qurbana may be fulfilled through my hands.
Pray for me, brothers and sisters. May God bless and strengthen you fulfill. May he accept the Qurbana and be pleased with the sacrifice you offer yourself for us, for the whole world. Amen.
Lord our God, we thank you for the abundant grace you have showered on us. For though we are sinful and weak, through your infinite mercy you have made us worthy to be ministers of the sacred mysteries of the body and blood of your anointed one. We implore you to strengthen us to celebrate with deep love and true faith these gifts that you have given us. We offer you praise and honor, worship and thanksgiving, now, always and forever.
Amen.
Peace be with you.
With you and with your spirit. My brothers and sisters, give peace to one another. In the love of Christ, let us thank the Lord and entreat him with a pure and contrite heart. Let us stand with a due reverence and be attentive into the offspring mysterials being celebrated here. The bishop is imploring that peace may flourish through his intercession. Bowing our heads, let us lift our thoughts to heaven and pray reverently and devotedly in your hearts. Peace be with us.
Yeah.
adorable name of your most blessed Trinity is worthy of honor from every mouth, thanksgiving from every tongue, and praise from every creature. For in your great kindness you created the world and everything in it, and showed humanity your immense mercy, multitudes of heavenly hosts and thousands upon thousands of holy angels, and hosts of spiritual ministers of fire and spirit, bow down and adore you, Most High, and they glorify your name and offer you worship, together with the holy cherubim and seraphim, praising you with a loud voice and ceasingly, they proclaim in one voice.
Us.
For the Supreme Pontiff Pope Francis, the Lord and the head of the universe,
universal church, for the major Archbishop Marjor, the head and the father of our church, for Bishop Mar Jacob, the father and the head of the diocese, for Archbishop Mar Matthew, for Bishops Joseph and Joy, priests, consecrated patients, lay missionaries, for the entire Holy Catholic Church, and for the rulers and all those who are in authority, Lord, mighty God, receive this Kurbana.
Lord, graciously receive this Kurbana.
For the honor and glory of all the prophets, disciples, martyrs, confessors, and all the guests and holy fathers who have found favor in your presence, Lord, receive this Kurbana.
Lord, graciously receive this Kurbana.
For all those who suffer and are in distress, the poor and the oppressed, the sick and the afflicted, for all those who have departed from us in your name, for these your people who await your mercy with great hope, for the newlywed couple Jimmy and Stephanie, and for me, for us, the unworthy servants, Lord, receive this Kurbana.
Lord, graciously receive this Kurbana.
Lord our God, as you taught us, we offer you the body and blood of your anointed one on this pure and holy altar. May we invoke in this memorial celebration the sacred memory of Mary, the Virgin Mother of God, and of the just and holy fathers who found favor in your presence through your infinite mercy. Grant us your peace and tranquility all the days of our lives. Let all the people on earth know that you alone are the true God, the Father, and that you sent your beloved Son, Jesus Christ. May all the people know that Christ, our Lord and God, in his life-giving gospel, came and taught us the way of purity and sanctity of the prophets and apostles, martyrs and confessors, doctors and bishops, priests and deacons, and all the children of the Holy Catholic Church who have been signed with the living and life-giving seal of baptism. Lord, we, your humble, weak and distressed servants, having received our example from generation to generation, have come together in your name and stand in your presence, rejoicing and glorifying. We commemorate and celebrate this great, awesome, holy, life-giving and divine mystery of the passion, death, burial and resurrection of our Lord and Savior, Jesus Christ.
Let us pray in silence and reverence. Peace be with us.
Lord our God, may your Holy Spirit descend on this Kurbana. Make it dwell on this Kurbana of your servants and bless and sanctify it. May this Kurbana grant us remission of our debts, forgiveness of our sins, great hope in the resurrection of the dead, new life in your heavenly kingdom, with all those who have found a favor in your presence. Lord our God, we offer you our unending praise for your glorious life-giving and for our salvation. We offer you thanksgiving with joy and hope in your church redeemed by the precious blood of your servant. We offer glory and honor, thanksgiving and worship to your living, holy and life-giving name, now, always and forever and ever. Have mercy on me, O God, in your loving kindness. Lord Jesus Christ, may there be glory to your name and worship to your majesty forever. For this living and life-giving bread has come down from heaven and gives life to the whole world. Whoever eats this bread will not die, but will receive remission of sins and attain salvation forever. of our Lord Jesus Christ, love of God the Father, and the fellowship of the Holy Spirit be with us all, now, always, and forever and ever.
Amen. Let us approach the mysteries of the precious body and blood of our Savior with reverence and respect, with the hope rising from repentance. Let us turn away from wrongdoing, repent our sins, and forgive the trespasses of our brothers and sisters. Let us pray to God, the Lord of all, for mercy and forgiveness. Let us cleanse our hearts, turning away from dissension and conflict. Let us free our soul from enmity and hatred. Let us receive the Holy Kurbana and be sanctified by the Holy Spirit. Let us receive these sacred mysteries of peace and unity with one another. O Lord, may these sacred mysteries be for the resurrection of our bodies and the salvation of our souls. Let us pray, peace be with us.
Lord our God, make us worthy to be in your presence with the confidence you have mercifully bestowed on us. Enable us to stand in your presence with a cheerful face and pure hearts. Calling upon you together, we pray. Our Father in heaven,
hallowed be thy name, the kingdom come, thou will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day the bread we need, the forgiveness of our debts and sins, and we have forgiven those who suffered us. Do not let us fall into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For yours is the kingdom, the power and glory, forever and ever. Amen.
Lord God Almighty, fullness of all goodness, our merciful Father, we entreat thee for your mercy. Do not lead us to temptation. Deliver us from the evil one, I release us. For yours is the kingdom, the might, the power, and the dominion in heaven and on earth, now, always, and forever and ever.
Amen. With you and with your spirit.
Holy Kurbana is for the holy people.
God the Father alone is holy. God the Son alone is holy. God the Spirit alone is holy. Glory be to the Father, the Son, the Holy Spirit, forever. Amen. Let us praise the living God.
May the grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, who gives us life, be made perfect in us through his mercy.
Always and forever. Amen. Brothers and sisters, the Holy Church invites you to receive the body and blood of our Son, or the Son of God, with faith and in heavenly kingdom.
Please stand. Lord God, stretch out your right hand of mercy upon this couple, Jimmy and Stephanie. Keep them in the shade of your protection. For God who blessed Abraham and Sarah, we thank you for the providence that bound them in indivisible unity. The Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit, the Lord of all forever.
Amen.
Lord Christ, look favorably upon this couple. May the intercessions of the Blessed Virgin Mary, our Mother, and St. Joseph, the head of the Holy Family, help them prosper in their family life. May the prayers of all the saints support them all the way, Lord of all, forever.
Amen.
Dear friends, before I do the final blessing, I just want to congratulate Jimmy and Stephanie once again, and the family of Barakudil and Joseph Ambly family for coming this close family relationship by the marriage of Jimmy and Stephanie. So it's, everything is working by the guidance of God. So there are a lot of things we have to thank the Lord for this wonderful wedding that has taken place here. And also I thank Father Muttolet having arranged all these things for you. And the choir did a good job. This wonderful choir you arranged it. And there are so many people, you dress the maids, all done very well and made this service very beautiful. And you all participated in the service very good. I just want to remind our youngsters who are standing behind, if you are not yet get married, you think about your marriage as early as possible. So I wish you all the best. And don't wait for another COVID to come, so you can get married soon. Okay, I wish you all the best. Now there is a tendency in our community that some of our youngsters, they think, oh no, I don't want to get married now. I can prolong it long time. Don't prolong it. Everything is decided by God to be done in appropriate time. So you have to do that in appropriate time, what is required by God. So you have to submit or surrender to God. So I invite all of our youngsters who have already got ready for their marriage. So God bless you.
Thank you. Good afternoon, everybody. Everyone could please have a seat. Hope everybody's doing all right. Right now, we're going to start taking family